Hello everyone, my name is Matthias Bengwa, a Technical Account Manager here at AWS. Today I am going to guide you through the process of migrating a web access control list from AWS WAF Classic to AWS WAF. We highly recommend doing this migration to benefit from the improved security, performance, and management capabilities offered by AWS WAF. To get us started, I will share some of the benefits of migrating from AWS WAF Classic to AWS WAF. The first benefit are the AWS managed rules for AWS WAF. The rule groups are an AWS managed service that provide protection against common web threats, and many of them are included free of charge with AWS WAF. An example is the core rule set that protects against common web threats and vulnerabilities published in the OWASP Top 10. We have different IP reputation rule groups that you can leverage to block traffic based on source IP. There are also paid for managed rule sets for bot control, fraud and account takeover prevention that you can use to better protect your applications. New API for regional and global configuration. In AWS WAF, management of both your global and regional resources is consolidated under a single API. You use a scope setting to distinguish between regional and global applications. The single API replaces the WAF and WAF regional APIs used in AWS WAF Classic. Improved rate-based rules. Rate-based rules react more quickly to traffic changes, improving your ability to respond to threats. They now allow for more customizations to the time window for evaluation and how requests are evaluated and aggregated. For example, you can evaluate on request characteristics such as IP address, HTTP method, and the URI. Rule nesting and logical operations. AWS WAF supports complex rule nesting and logical operations. For example, you can create a complex rule to evaluate for a condition A and not B or C. Variable side arrange support. There is now added flexibility with subnet masks that you can configure in AWS WAF. For IPv4 addresses, you can configure a subnet mask of /1 to /32. Similarly, for IP version 6, you can configure /1 to /128. Document-based rule writing. This feature allows you to write and manage rules, rule groups, and web access control lists in JSON format. This streamlined approach eliminates the need for individual APIs to create conditions and associate them with rules. Instead, you can directly access and work with the JSON representation of your web access control lists through the console. Chainable text transformations. AWS WAF can perform multiple text transformations against web request content before inspecting it. Expanded file manager policy. You now have the ability to create two different sets of rule groups. The first set will be processed by AWS WAF initially, while the second set will be processed last. Local account owners can add their own rule groups, which AWS WAF will process in between these two predefined sets. This feature provides more flexibility and control over the order in which rule groups are evaluated, enabling you to better manage and prioritize your security rules. CloudFormation support. AWS WAF integration with AWS CloudFormation supports all rule statement types that are available through the AWS WAF console and API. This full support ensures consistency and compatibility across different methods of managing your AWS WAF rules. Additionally, AWS CloudFormation simplifies the process of working with rules written in JSON format by allowing you to easily convert them to YAML format. Access control list limits are now based on compute needs. These compute needs are expressed as Web Access Control List Capacity Units, a WCU in short, which represent the operating resources needed to run the rules. The total capacity units required for a Web Access Control List is the sum of all the WCUs of all its rules and rule groups. It is also now easier to actually see these limits as they are displayed in the console. In the next section, we'll go over the available migration options. There are three migration options available suited to different use cases. The first option is manual migration, and this involves manually recreating your existing AWS WAF Classic resources in AWS WAF. You can choose to use the console or the CLI or the SDK. This option is suited for small WAF deployments where you can manually recreate the web access control list in a short time. the switch from AWS WAF Classic to AWS WAF might cause a brief disruption. Keep this in mind when you plan your migration. The second option is for deployments that are using the AWS security automations for AWS WAF Classic. In such a scenario, you have to deploy a new AWS security automations template created for AWS WAF. After creating the web access control list for AWS WAF, make sure to tune and test the AWS WAF protections before you implement the rules in production. Please scan the QR code to get the AWS security automations template for AWS WAF. The final option is to use the AWS WAF Classic Migration Wizard. This tool is used to automatically migrate your existing AWS WAF Classic resources to AWS WAF. You should use this tool if you have complex AWS WAF Classic deployments. It is important to note that there are some configurations that the Migration Wizard does not migrate for you. We will discuss these in more details in the next section. In this section, we'll explore some important considerations for smooth migration. First is that the migration scope covers a single account. You can only migrate AWS WAF Classic resources to AWS WAF resources within the same account. Second is that managed rules from AWS Marketplace sellers are not migrated by the wizard. You will need to resubscribe to the Marketplace rule group for AWS WAF after the migration to continue getting protections from the rule group. Before resubscribing to Marketplace rule groups, take a look at the AWS managed rules included with AWS WAF for free, as they may be able to provide the protections that you need. Third is that the migration wizard does not bring over any associations between your web access control list and protected resources. This is designed to prevent disruptions in your production environment. After verifying that your migration is successful, you will need to manually associate your new web access control list with your resources. The fourth caveat is that, by default, logging for the migrated web access control list is disabled. This is intentional to give you control over when to enable logging during the transition. Be sure to enable logging when you are ready to fully switch over from AWS WAF Classic to AWS WAF. The fifth one is that the migration wizard does not handle rule groups managed by AWS Firewall Manager. You can migrate a web access control list managed by AWS Firewall Manager, but the rule groups will not be transferred. Instead, recreate the new policy for AWS WAF within AWS Firewall Manager to ensure continuity. And finally, do not migrate AWS security automations for AWS WAF Classic using the migration wizard. The reason is that the migration tool does not convert Lambda functions that are used by these automations. Instead, deploy the security automations template for AWS WAF. In this section, I shall demonstrate a migration using the AWS WAF Classic Migration Wizard. I have now logged into my AWS account and navigated to the AWS WAF and AWS Shield console. I will click Go to AWS WAF, and this will take me into my AWS WAF Classic console. I'm in the North Virginia region, and I have one web access control list that I am going to migrate to AWS WAF using the migration wizard. Before I begin the migration, I will open my web access control list and look at the rules configured. I have a total of 10 rules on this web access control list. I will navigate back to my web access control list. And now I will start the migration wizard. I will do that by clicking on the migration wizard link, which is in the information banner at the top of the page. Next, I will now select the web access control list I want to migrate. I do this by choosing the region and the web access control list. I'm using the North Virginia region, so I will go ahead and select the web access control list. I will now move on to make the migration configuration. For the migration, I must choose an S3 bucket to be used by CloudFormation during the migration. I have not pre-provisioned the bucket, so I will use the Create New option. This redirects me to my Amazon S3 console, where I will create a new bucket. Make sure your bucket is in the same region as your web access control list and the bucket name is prefixed with AWS-WAF-Migration-. I will name my bucket AWS-WAF-Migration-Video-Demo. I'm accepting all the other settings as default, so I scroll to the bottom of the page and click Create New Bucket. My Amazon S3 bucket has been created, and I now have an empty bucket. I will navigate back to my migration wizard console, and I will click refresh and click on the dropdown to select the bucket. For the S3 bucket policy, best practice is to use auto-apply the bucket policy required for migration to avoid permission issues. If you choose to use the bucket policy that comes with the S3 bucket, make sure to configure the appropriate permissions required by the migration. The final step on this page is to configure how to handle rules that cannot be migrated. Best practice is to exclude rules that cannot be migrated. This allows the migration to complete, but you'll have to manually add any rules that have been excluded. You can opt to stop the migration if some rules cannot be migrated, if that suits your requirements. To move forward, I will click Next. On this page, I see a summary of the migration details I made earlier. I wish to proceed with these configurations, so I click Start Creating CloudFormation Template to move forward. The template creation process may take a few minutes to complete. Do not navigate away from this window while the template is being created. To continue with the migration, I click Create CloudFormation Stack. This redirects me to my CloudFormation console. Create Stack Configuration Settings. I will accept the defaults and move forward by clicking Next. Here, I will change the stack name, AWS WAF Migration Demo, and click Next. Next, you can configure the stack options to meet your requirements. I will accept the default settings and choose Next.
Finally, I review my configuration and scroll to the bottom, click on Submit, and this kicks off the stack creation process. The stack has been fully created, so now I navigate back to my Migration Wizard console and I click on Close.
This takes me into my AWS WAF console in the North Virginia region, and I now have a new web access control list that has just been created. I'll open the web access control list to take a look at the rules. I can see that all 10 rules have been migrated. If you discover that some of your rules have not been migrated, add the configuration for the skipped rules to your web access control list. To check the rule configuration, I can click on a rule name and go through the details view. Alternatively, I can take a look at the JSON view. As best practice, we recommend cleaning up or optimizing your configuration from AWS WAF Classic by rewriting the rules or using AWS managed rules to replace your self-managed rules where possible. I will show an example by replacing my self-managed SQL injection rule with an AWS managed rule set for SQL databases. I do that by clicking Add Rules and then Add Manage Rules. Here you can see all the managed rules from AWS and AWS Marketplace Sellers. I am interested in the SQL database rule set under the AWS Managed Rule Groups. I will toggle this button to add it to my web access control list and then scroll down to the bottom and click Add Rules. Next, I will adjust the priority for the rule and move it just above my self-managed SQLi injection rule and save. Now under rules in my web access control list, you can see I have added the AWS managed rules SQLi rule set. I can now delete my WAF demo mitigate SQLi. Please note that we highly recommend that you test the AWS managed rule set before using them to replace your self-managed rules in your production environment. When you have completed your testing and you are now ready to switch over from AWS WAF Classic to AWS WAF, we recommend that you go under Logging and Metrics and enable your logging before you associate any AWS resources to your web access control list. After you have enabled your logging, you can then go to Associated AWS Resources and add AWS resources to your web access control list. In my case, I will be adding an AWS application load balancer. Click on Add. This adds the application load balancer as a protected resource to my web access control list. So this is an example of how you can use the AWS WAF Classic Migration Wizard to migrate from AWS WAF Classic to AWS WAF.
For more detailed guides and resources, scan the provided QR code. Finally, thank you for watching and happy cloud computing from all of us here at AWS.